Okay. I'd have to leave at like 9:40-ish, because there's not going to be traffic out there.
Gotcha. All right, so game one of Grand Finals, RJ versus I.
Hello. I, the person who lost and loses violence.
We feel that.
Oh!
That is very interesting. He literally went through her legs. I'm pretty sure that if we like went to the replay and showed that angle, he went right through her legs.
I think that's just a Squirtle side before.
It might just be. F throw nearly killing, but not quite enough.
Because if it doesn't, I assume if it does not detect any collision, it'll just keep going.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know how it didn't detect collision, but it didn't. So I assume it just kept going. Indeed. That was not weird though.
It was definitely super weird. Did Squirtle keep an eye on the opponent like at all times? Because like when he was crouched down, never mind. Besides the point, RJ up a stock already.
Okay, Zai knowing that the second F tilt is not safe on block.
Mm-hmm.
The first one, the initial is safe, mm-hmm. but if you keep doing it, it stays on your block. So the second one is not safe.
Sort of another, yeah.
That was a good shield grab, so just grab it.
So like a ninja down tilt. Ooh, fair off stage, yes. The Charizard comes out, one of the beefier characters in the game, and one of RJ's better characters at that. Oh my lordy Jesus, that,
was that so
worked.
Near
he just fell, and it worked.
I think that. Here's a hot take. I think the Pokemon trainer nerfs were actually buffs. Never mind, just died.
Except that one. I
think Ivy getting nerfed doesn't matter that much because Ivy wasn't even the good character out of the
No,
three.
He wasn't. It just kind of like.
Ivy's a girl.
Word up. It just kind of like put the focus on the other two characters and people were able to like theorize and actually practice with those characters more now that they knew that Ivysaur was like not the best character in their minds.
I think it's Squirtle, Charizard, Ivy.
I agree. I wholeheartedly agree.
I think Squirtle is just like water Pikachu.
Has the mobility of like a Pikachu Diddy type, the fair of a Diddy. It's ridiculous.
And Charizard is just like DK, bro. Imagine doing Pikachu damage and switching to DK.
So last stock situation, the two frame into the back air, and that connects because of Charizard's big old body.
It's also just down tilt being mad disjointed.
Yeah, it's true.
That helps.
Especially, like, we saw the spacing there from Zai. Like, Zai was, like, a little behind the ledge and put the down tilt out, and the down tilt was still able to cover the recovery from that distance out. Like, he can be a distance away, and it can still cover a two frame option like that.
Here's also a fun fact. Apparently, if you, like, you know how if Ness hits you with up B, it shortens?
Yeah.
Like, apparently, it's the same way with Charizard.
That makes sense.
That's what RJ told me.
That makes sense.
I feel inclined to believe that. It may make sense.
Yeah. If that's really the case, catch me dropping down to Charizard when he coming up from deep.
As Lucario, I just counter it.
Yeah, you're right.
Because
I counter it too, yeah.
Because Lucario just goes through the entire stage and then just recovers the other side.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And the thing is, either Charizard goes into the stage and untackables, or he goes out, depending on which way I decide to do it.
And if I do it as Greninja, I could just go straight down because after the first 7 frames, I believe, he is no longer invincible and I can hit him with anything.
Yeah, I know that.
Yeah, it's the startup of Uppy that's invincible. Because we saw it at the weekly on Wednesday. I believe it was when he was playing against Yam. He was recovering onto stage. And as Yam threw a Nikita out, he used the Uppy right as the Nikita was about to hit him, was not knocked away, and managed to recover from the distance. So it's the startup of Uppy that has the invincibility, but the rest of the Uppy does not.
Interdesting.
So once again, same characters. I did miss the banter between all the banter that was going on between the two of them.
I have to be awake until 6 a.m. today, and I my brain not functioning. I made a mistake.
We can leave early and you can nap in the car.
That's fine. All
right, so.
Sheer willpower.
Sheer willpower? All right, you got it.
Running it back to PS2.
Can't blame him for the counter. Can't blame him from the stage pick. He was very close in the first game. He understands that it's still a good stage for Pokemon Trainer, because what bad stage does this character have, really?
FD.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
I think FD is like one of the only ones. And then by default, I guess like Kalos, potentially Town.
Mm-hmm.
Three FDs. Because you don't have platform extensions. And Squirtle is a very platform extension heavy character. Without Plats, Squirtle gets like 40-ish. And then with Plats, usually you can extend it to 60 depending on how optimal the combo is.
Right, right. 65, I believe, is the magic number.
Or you can at least like extend it. And reset.
Speaking of extension and reset, oh, he almost had it again.
Now that's a privilege.
For real. Back air coming out, he won't air dodge it. Smart stuff, super good. That's great awareness of his own habits. Back throw, yeet. Won't kill just yet. RJ has kept him at this ledge for the past minute of this game, dude. does teleport on stage, and just like that comes back with an option. Dang, Squirtle really does sound like he's in pain there.
So that, like, Squirtle right there, besides being the combo-heavy character, is also the character that throws you at ledge the easiest. In contention with Charizard, what Charizard does it is never, is not necessarily with, like...
Uh-oh, switch again, jump, up B, counter, nicely done. He will not be able to recover.
No! The angle is just mad. Gonna read that spot, dog.
Absolutely, absolutely. 85% of this... Oh, okay, you had it, you had it. Yeah, I see your point. If he managed to get that third up air and convert it from there, I think he would have done another up tilt to keep the combo going. But then again, there's always Nair to break things up, so I can't say for sure.
An interesting tidbit is that Ivy, just like, her out of shield option is not very great. So when you're playing as Ivy, you are literally just a zoner.
The whole time.
Because getting hit on your block is really difficult, because Nair is your best out of shield option. It doesn't really lead to anything, and it's not necessarily very good.
It's really her only get off me tool, if that's the case. Because the down tilt is quickish, but it's only so short.
You're still dropping frames also.
Yeah, that's true.
To drop your shield.
As opposed to nairing in the first place, which just gets the nair out.
You can't up B either, because it's like...
Why?
I mean, it's not fast, so I don't think, and it's like...
Gets the up B out of...
Let's just mash out.
That's crazy. Charizard has an up B out of shield and up B out of disadvantage, and has this move, the most terrifying move in the game to get hit by. Oh, the tech chase. That was a Pokemon capture and a half right there. Palutena really extra with it out here. Down throwing and... Oh, nice, nice.
I don't know why Zai didn't go for fair. I think he didn't want to risk getting up aired.
Yeah.
That move is as big as the pollen. So it's not, this is the initial and then there's like the pollen part. I think he footstooled it.
Yeah, he's dead. Goodness gracious. When he did the dare, I think at that point he was just dead. Because, like, he had the potential to come back.
I think he could have switched jump up beat. Potentially.
Yes. And like, there's no doubt that Ivy does have range on that upbeat to get back to the ledge. But, like, it just didn't seem like he was going to get back from that distance.
I don't know if Ivy works this way, because some tether recovers, I think, too.
Yeah.
If there is a body in the way, it'll prioritize the body.
I think that's the case. I know that's the case.
Joker's is not like that, but his is special. I think most tethers prioritize the body that is in the way.
Okay. Let's see. There's Young Link. There's...
Young Link, Toon Link.
The Samuses. Zero Suit Samus. Joker.
I don't know if Icy's work that way.
I doubt it, because it's a hitbox anyway. It's not really a command grab or anything like that. Like, it just throws them out there to begin with. So it's kind of a determined angle.
They have weird properties, so it would not surprise me if it worked that way.
Yeah.
I think that's it. I think that's all the tethers.
I can't remember.
Oh, the Belmonts.
Yes, the Belmonts, the fairs and the up airs.
I think the fairs and bears prioritize bodies that are in the way.
That would probably make sense. So once again, running it back for the third game of the set, potentially the last one of Grand Finals. Zai's up 2-0 in quick fashion, but...
I think what makes this weird really difficult is that Palu is good on most of PT's counterpick stages.
Yes.
Like Battlefield or Yoshi's Story.
So you're not really counterpicking her. You're more so counterpicking the player in this instance. You have to counterpick the player. Otherwise, you're just stuck with the stage.
It's like your level of comfortability.
Yeah.
You have to hope that they're not better than you on the stage you're trying to CP to.
A very similar start to this game is the very last one, but not for long. Very quickly, this sequel turns out to be a very different movie than its predecessor. Ooh, that ledge move was a little bit filthy. Looking for the jab lock, not able to find it. Zai too aware.
I wonder... if CPing like Smashville might have been a little better. Because like Palu doesn't inherently do that well.
Right.
I mean, it's like it's still a platform, so she like does well.
But it's also not... a smaller stage. You don't have to, I know Zai has been committing more so towards
big stages.
Like big stages. Not only that, but hasn't really been as passive in this set, mostly because he's been at a deficit for most of the game. But if that's the case, then why not go with the Smash Bros? Because there's nowhere for her to run. There's nowhere for Palu to run, even if Zai does get a lead.
Right.
Ooh, up beats a pass the ledge. Smart, smart. Gets him off him.
High risk, high reward.
Mm-hmm.
Or rather, high risk, medium reward. But sometimes you just gotta do those things when you're down.
Big facts, big facts. Looking for these hits. Zai comes out with a back air. That's the one that'll do it. And now it's a matter of getting that stock up for RJ so he can get himself back into this game. Otherwise, it could spiral out of control.
All right.
There it is.
We're going to do the falling up air.
Nice.
That's how Ivy's kind of like bread and butter. It's kind of like how she steals your stock.
Yeah. Like Charizard, we know what steals all the stocks.
Who's Tiffy, I guess.
Ivysaur up air for sure. Down air kind of, but you're kind of
down air
mix
up. It's like if you get down air on a plat.
Oh
it's
yeah.
Like maybe.
Oh. And the pop up from the F smash. My man was feeling it on that one. Great read. Gets the stock off and 7.5% on this final stock of RJ. Potentially again, last game of the set. We'll see where Zai goes from here. RJ needs to get himself back into the game, and it's very hard now that he's on the ledge for once and getting ledge trapped here.
And Ivy, not a good character, like sitting at ledge.
Mm-mm.
Like we discussed, not very good at shield options. Burst options are basically non-existent.
Very good from a faraway distance. The better the spacing, the better the play for the character.
The zoner character out of the three.
Yes.
Like the one that hard zones.
Not just in projectile, but in like aerial usage, normal usage, everything. True zoner. Charizard, on the other hand, a straight brawler. He will duff your chin in, and he's looking to do exactly that, but Palu's chin and shield and back air and dash attack and fair are just a little bit too strong right now.
They're not going to kill yet, so I assume he just waited it out so that we can keep it unstaled.
Right.
There's also a freshness bonus that people forget, that if your moves are unstaled, they are stronger inherently.
Two back airs in a row off the ledge. He will have the chance to get the kill. Doesn't quite get the kill.
Unfortunate.
Great tech from RJ. He will live a little bit longer, but needs to get off this ledge versus Palutena. This is the only character he can really utilize until he gets the chance to get the stock. Otherwise, he might be able to switch to Ivy, but it's not all that great, knowing that Ivy has one predetermined playstyle. Tries to risk
betting
it for the biscuit,
all.
But that'll do it.
Never hurts.
Never hurts to try.
Gotta give it a go.
Mm-hmm.
Zai, wait. Zai.
All right, so that'll be the tournament. Zai takes it 3-0 over RJ. Very clean stuff. I don't think he lost.